Hello everyone. Today I'll be talking about replication of DNA. Especially in this lecture, I will focus on pre-priming complex formation. What is replication? Replication is nothing but making the exact copy of DNA. Replication is mainly divided into three steps. What are these three steps? That I'll tell you. I'll just take my laser pointer. Okay. Now, replication is studied in three steps. First one is initiation, elongation, and termination. In initiation, I'll be covering the structure of OEC, pre-priming complex formation, priming reaction. Okay, and in this lecture, I'll cover the first two topic, that is the structure of OEC gene and pre-priming complex formation. Whereas in my second video, I'll cover this priming reaction. Now, OEC, what is this OEC? In all cases, a replication starts at a particular point. That is known as origin. The origin of replication in case of E. coli, it is called as a OEC. And where this OEC is present, it is at the location of AT2. What do I mean by AT2? That I'll explain in my next slide. Now, the OEC gene is almost 248 base pair long. And important is that it is AT region. Now, this is the genome organization of E. coli. In order to understand the location of various genes, this entire circle is divided into 100 parts. Now, accordingly, the position of OEC is at 82, means this is the point where OEC gene is present. This OEC gene, it consists of 4 repeats of 9 base pair and 3 repeats of 15 base pair. Now, these 9 base pair repeats or 13 base pair repeats, these sequences are known as consensus sequence. What is mean by consensus sequence? These sequences are conserved sequence. It means this does not undergo much more changes. These are the reserved sequences. And OEC gene get characterized by the presence of 4, 9 base pair consensus sequence and 3, 13 base pair consensus sequences. Now, these 9 base pair sequences has got importance because these are known as the binding site for DNA A protein. DNA A protein can recognize these 9 base pair sequences and it binds to this site. And whereas it start unwinding DNA at 13 base pair sequences. Now let's see the diagrammatically how exactly it binds and cause the unwinding of DNA. This is the supercoil template of double-stranded DNA. And this is nothing but the OEC gene. You can see very clearly 4 repeats of 9 base pair sequence, whereas 3 repeats of 13 base pair sequences, which are shown in yellow color. Now, DNA A protein, with the help of ATP, it recognize the 9 base pair sequence and bind over here. And this is known as the closed complex formation. Next to this, histone-like protein with the help of ATP. It somehow supports the unwinding of DNA at 13 base pair sequences. And this unwinding is it takes place at 13 base pair sequence, and this is known as open complex formation. You can see this is the open complex formation. Okay, next to this, it is the DNA B which comes in the picture. Here, DNA B protein, it binds to the single stranded DNA. This DNA B protein, actually, it is known as the helicase protein. It recognizes this unwinding site. It cannot recognize it actually. For this, the DNA C protein helps the DNA B protein to recognize this unwinding site, and it binds to this single-stranded DNA. DNA B protein is known as the helicase enzyme, and this helicase, it comes in the hexamer form and it binds over here. This is known as the pre-priming complex formation. This pre-priming complex formation, again, I will explain with this another diagram. See, this is the ORIC gene with 4 repeats of 9 mers and 3 repeats of 13 base pairs. And now the DNA A protein, which can bind to the 9 base pair repeats, it binds over here, and because of binding of DNA A protein to 9 base pairs, the 13 base pair, it comes near to the DNA A protein. This is known as the initial complex. Now, with the help of histone-like protein and energy in the form of ATP, unwinding of DNA takes place at 13 base pair. Now, as the unwinding begins at the 13 base pair, this 13 base pair get characterized by the presence of AT-rich region. And because of AT-rich region, the number of hydrogen bonds which are present over here, those are comparatively less, and hence less energy is required for breaking of this hydrogen bonds, means less energy is required for unwinding of the DNA. Once the unwinding has taken place, this is known as the open complex. Now, the helicase enzyme, that is the DNA B protein, comes in the picture. But DNA B protein cannot bind to this unwinding region, and therefore DNA C protein helps the DNA B protein. Here it is shown that DNA C protein binds to DNA B protein, and both of this protein comes over here. DNA C protein, it only helps this DNA B to bind at this unwinding site. Once the DNA B protein is bind to the unwinding DNA, DNA C protein leaves this complex, and this is known as the pre-priming complex. And this DNA B protein, actually, it comes in the ring form, and 6 subunit of this DNA B unite with each other, and therefore it is known as the hexamer. So 2 different ring like hexamers, they bind to the 2 strands of the DNA. One of this ring-like structure, means one helicase, it will move in this direction. It will keep on breaking the hydrogen bond, and thus more and more single-stranded DNA will be available. Similarly, this another ring-like structure, another hexamer of helicase. It will move in this direction and it will keep on breaking the hydrogen bond. Thus, more and more single stranded DNA will be available for the replication purpose, and this complex is known as the pre-priming complex. Again, I will explain that the two different proteins are present in the pre-priming complex, and these are nothing but the DNA E protein and DNA B protein. But if we want to summarize, like, what are different proteins which are involved in the formation of pre-priming complex, then number one is the DNA A protein, which can recognize the 9 base pair sequence, and it can unwind the DNA at 13 base pair sequence. Second one is the DNA C, which helps the DNA B protein to bind to the single-stranded DNA, and next third one is the DNA B protein, which is known as the helicase enzyme, which actually responsible for breaking the hydrogen bond. Here is the summary of the three proteins which actually involve in the pre-priming complex formation. Number one, DNA A, it recognizes the ORIC sequence for the initiation of replication. DNA B protein, which unwinds the DNA, which is known as the helicase. And DNA C protein, it helps the helicase enzyme to recognize the site for its action. So thus, up till now, we have seen the importance of these three proteins in the formation of pre-priming complex. Thank you.